Most people know that their tweets and Instagram posts are monitored. We voluntarily dump a ton of personal data into the world, and that's valuable for advertisers, scientists, law enforcement, you name it. But few people think about another form of personal data that can be even more revealing. It's ubiquitous, highly personal, hard to fake, and could be used against us. You're listening to it right now, and you're probably going to comment saying that I have vocal fry. It's our voices. Voices reveal a lot about us, our personality, our health, our mood, and thanks to smart assistants like the Amazon Echo and Google Home, we're getting used to talking to devices all the time. A recent poll from Gallup found that about 22% of Americans use smart assistants. Naturally, companies want us to talk to their devices even more, and potentially give up the secrets in our voices. So the key to the insights we're talking about isn't actually what we say, but how we say it.
Meaning, not the content of speech, not words of speech, the physics of speech created from the waveforms from the human voice box.
Charles Marmer is the chair of the psychiatry department at New York University Medical School. He's been studying post-traumatic stress disorder for decades and has done a lot of work into finding vocal biomarkers for PTSD. These are the building blocks for pulling meaning out of your voice. At the very broadest level, biomarkers can involve things like the tone of our voice, the speed we talk at, the way we emphasize words, and the pauses between words. But that's just the beginning. Using machine learning, Charles has studied the speech of people with PTSD and found about 18 much more nuanced markers that we might not even notice.
They're tiny biophysical features, but in general, they represent speech which is flatter, less emotional, and less variable.
This wouldn't only work with PTSD either. The same technique could be used with many conditions, and each could have its own set of unique vocal biomarkers.
I think for depression, for other forms of anxiety, probably for bipolar disorder, particularly mania, where you would have loud, highly forceful, high volume, high intensity speech. There might be some characteristic changes in voice that signal that someone's drifting towards a psychotic risk.
Right now, Charles relies on very high quality recordings and a powerful computer system. But the hope is that one day, it can be streamlined into something simple that lots of people can use and find helpful.
Something simpler that could be used in the form of an app or something that would be in the cloud.
That's not just a theoretical idea. In fact, one company called Companion MX has already made a mood analysis app. Basically, patients record audio diaries into the app, an AI analyzes them, and shares the results with the patient and their doctor.
And what we've seen this does is now the patient, if they're doing better, they know they're getting better. They can see that they're getting better. And they can also see when things are not going so well.
The app is only available to clinicians right now. But we asked Companion MX chief executive, Sub Dada, to tell us how it works.
The patient is required to leave an audio diary, which is basically where they speak to the app or speak to the phone, at least a minimum of once a week and for a minimum of 10 seconds. And it takes the first 7 days to capture the baseline data. And after that, the analysis and the display of data starts. So what we have seen as a result of that is this brings the patient and the clinician together more. And the patient becomes significantly more engaged.
But beyond medicine, some businesses are applying the technology in ways that start to feel concerning. An Israeli startup called VoiceSense promises to do voice analysis on everything from a customer's investment style to employee hiring and turnover. In one example, it ran its algorithm on recordings from debtors. The results were intriguing. 6% of the predicted low-risk people defaulted, compared to 27% of the high-risk subjects. Another experiment looked at the probability that employees would leave. About 13% of the low-risk workers left, compared to 39% of the high-risk group. VoiceSense claims it can create a full personality profile using voice, an application that is far more ambitious than Charles and his PTSD screenings. But Charles is pretty skeptical of such big claims.
I can only tell you it's really hard to validate these tests. And one should start with modest claims and build on them. In science, great oaks from little acorns grow.
And reckless research could put people's health at risk.
Because you'll end up with false positives and false negatives. So you'll end up people saying they can diagnose depression, but they'll overdiagnose it in some people and underdiagnose it in others.
Other experts are worried about what this means for privacy, especially if these small studies aren't that accurate. What if you're denied a mortgage because software mistakenly flags you as a risky customer? What does this mean even if the systems are accurate? What privacy rights are we waiving just by opening our mouths?
The world we live in, the Google, Facebook, Siri world we live in, is one in which we have very limited privacy. And certainly unscrupulous operators could make inferences about all kinds of things, like, are you someone who wants to buy a Jaguar convertible from your voice? How do I know?
Ultimately, it's hard to ignore those home assistants sitting in our living rooms. More and more, they're providing huge companies with countless hours of our voices. The big tech companies are not involved in this kind of work now, but they're sitting on a gold mine of data. So it's not hard to imagine a future where we're surrounded by devices that capture and analyze our every utterance. What they do with that info is anyone's guess.
Siri. Hey, Siri.
Hey, Siri. Okay, Apple.
Okay.